Final Fantasy XV is a big game with a big vision, and the designers and artists needed an engine that could live up to that. The biggest challenge on the graphics side is that everything is dynamic. So you could say, okay guys, we're going next gen, let's put in a physically based lighting system and global illumination and all that. But then you say, oh, and by the way, thick clouds can roll in at any time. Or you could be indoors 1 minute and the next minute you're not anymore because some big monster came and ripped the roof off the building. That's the kind of game we're dealing with here.
The character's skin needs to look like it's not just a surface, but that light goes into the skin, bounces around, and comes back out. That the car paint shader looked like real car paint with layers, a base coat, metal flake, and top coat on top of it. Final Fantasy XV is a fantasy based on reality, so the art designers have created incredibly high detailed models that we've never had before, and the shaders need to step it up to match. So we needed to go with physically based shaders.
料理は、光の透過率や、柔らかさ、これらを素材ごとに変えなければいけないんですけれども、新しいシェーダーを使うことによってこれらがきれいに表現できるようになりました。皆さんに本当に美味しそうだなって感じてもらえる料理が作れるんじゃないかなと思っています。
シェーダーが物理ベースになることで、当然ライト側も現実と同じようになるべきです。我々は照明一つ一つを計測し、それを数値に落とし込んでいます。輝度や照射範囲を確定したライトアセットがあれば、街の照明配置が正しくデザインできますし、太陽の光も HDR で1日分を計測していますので、ゲーム画面の露出が現実の昼夜と同じスケールを持つことができています。
When speaking of the Final Fantasy games, like, I think a lot of people might think of the effect. Like with the new system, we can generate like a lot more particles, like tons of particles, and we can let them move and interact with the environment by their own.
So one of the big focuses for Final Fantasy XV is really to ground our animations in the environment in a realistic way.
As much as possible, our goal is to remove any of the disconnects in character motions in nearby terrain, objects, and dynamic forces. We've got a lightweight Parker system, so you'll have some freedom to navigate over fences and other obstacles. Humans and monsters will look around dynamically. We do a good job making sure that limbs, etc., aren't going to penetrate the environment. We've also got a homegrown system to physically animate clothing, hair, and grass. Most deaths are ragdoll influenced, so you'll even be able to sever some body parts. Also, we're starting to make use of physics-based character control, so like humans and monsters balancing and dynamically reacting to damage.
Lumina Studio の event timeline で各社動いてるんですけど、今回新たにパフォーマンスキャプチャーでの収録を行ってます。ボディとフェイシャルを同時に収録するので、よりリアルな表現が可能になっています。
AI キャラクターはこの様々な環境を自分の目で見て、自分の頭で考えて、自分で行動を決めて活動しています。 Lumina Studio の AI ドラフェイチャーでは、そういった AI キャラクターの頭脳をゲームの中で再現するための強力なツールになっています。
Within AI, one of the fundamental things that we want to express is movementIt's easy to phrase things in data, such as close to the street vendors but far away from the cats, and somewhere visible to the players. So we wanted designers to have all the power needed to express what they wanted in the highly complex environments of Final Fantasy XV.
Well, we have a really large team of talented artists here, and to bring all of their creative visions to life,We need an engine that we can customize at a very specific level.
As a graphics programmer, there's nothing better than being paired with a great art team who can really realize the full potential of the tech. And Square Enix has some amazing artists, always pushing the tech to its limits. And the end result is a gorgeous looking game.
PEGI 16.
どの辺まで行く？
時間はまだいっぱいあるね。俺たちのんびりやってるよね。
時間気にしてねえからな。
そろそろ食事でもするか。
PEGI 16.
Thank you. I'm Jim Curry, and in Final Fantasy XV, I played King Regis.
You have no cause for concern.
Nor do you.
Take heed. Once you set forth, you cannot turn back.
King Regis is a very wise, loyal, courageous ruler, and he has to make some tough decisions. What stood out about him to me was his love for his family, his willingness to protect his people.
My name is Ray Chase, and I play Noctis Lucis Calum in Final Fantasy XV. Don't know about you, but I'm ready as I'll ever be. What's interesting about Noctis is he's not your average, ordinary prince who goes on to try to save the world. He definitely doesn't go into it because he wants to. He's going into it because all of this is forced upon him out of nowhere. Over the course of the game, he learns what it means to be a hero. He learns humanity through the course of this game. And he loses a lot, too.
I'd like to be alone right now. Give me some space.
I'm sorry for intruding on Noctime. Well, I'll head back then. Night.
My name is Robbie Daymond, and I play Prompto in Final Fantasy XV. Well, when I first read for Prompto, you know, immediately I recognized his archetype from Final Fantasy series. But I didn't want to play him as just straight comedy relief. So even though that's sort of his function within the Four, we wanted to be really careful to make sure that he was grounded and human and still believable, being a real person going through his own journey.
So any bright ideas, Ignis?
A dark one, as it were. A frontal assault would leave us exposed, but if we move under cover of night, we might be able to infiltrate the base unnoticed.
Hi, my name's Adam Crosdell, and I play Ignis in Final Fantasy XV. Ignis is the confidant to the King-in-Waiting, Noct, and he is very cerebral, quite funny without meaning to be, and an organizer, extremely organized and extremely capable.
I'll analyze what intelligence we have available to find us a way in.
Sounds good, Specs.
He tries to keep Noct and the lads out of trouble and has varying degrees of success doing it.
I gotcha! Pull yourself up!
My name's Chris Parson, and in Final Fantasy XV, I play Gladio. Gladio is a guy who is... he has a soft spot, but at the same time, he's a ferocious guy that you do not want to cross. That's the thing that is really appealing about the Gladio character, is that he is a tough guy, and he is a comical guy, but at the same time, he cares deeply about his crew. He's kind of the papa bear of the crew.
It is in receiving mercy that men offer praise, and in shedding grace that the gods elicit worship.
I'm Amy Shields, and I play Luna Freya in Final Fantasy XV. I would describe Luna as a very strong woman. She's quite reserved, but still manages to give, of course, this major passion for everything in life that she cares about. She is this wonderful spirit who just cares about everyone else.
I vow! The king will prove himself worthy.
She's informed, she's educated, she's an incredible woman to play.
And what's your story?
I'm an impatient traveler, ready to turn ship. A man of no consequence.
Well, hi there. I'm Darren DePaul, and I play Arden Azunia in Final Fantasy XV and in Kingsglaive. The most enjoyable part of playing Arden, the writing. He's a wonderfully written character. He's very human because he has so many different sides. He's got that very sincere insincerity, and I adored that about him.
Arden Azunia, Chancellor of Niflheim. He's just so oily, but just so much fun.
That day, he didn't want you to remember him as the king. In what time you had left, he wanted to be your father.
My name is Matthew Mercer, and I play the role of Kor in Final Fantasy XV. Corleonis is a person who's bound by honor, he's bound by the promises he's made to his friends and to his king, and he's very much kind of a station of the old guard. What draws me to him is his sense of honor, his sense of duty, but also the fact that the failure is taken so strongly to heart that he wants to ensure that he makes up for his mistakes. No matter what the cost to him.
The king entrusted the role of protector to you.
Entrusted it to me? Then why didn't he tell me that? Why did he stand there smiling as I left? Why?
I think the story of Final Fantasy XV is the hallmark of this game.
It really is a classic coming-of-age story. And in the end, it's Nock's story. But the beautiful part about it is that his three friends who surround him the closest all take their individual journeys.
Things like father and son, brother to brother. These are real-life things that I think people can relate to. I was thrilled with how high the stakes were, always. People really lose something.
It's thrilling and it's sad and you're just getting to use everything.
It's heart-pounding in terms of how exciting it is.
It's an epic quest. It's a tale of betrayal, a tale of friendships for life, and a tale of triumph against insurmountable odds.
There's a lot of that fresh delivery that creates its own story and its own essence beyond the rest of the series before it, but also has enough of that continued thread of love that all the previous games had, where you feel like it's still home the Final Fantasy series always was. That, to me, is a sign of a true successor to what is probably one of the greatest game series to hit the whole genre and market.
I don't think there's anyone on the planet that isn't familiar with the world of Final Fantasy.
It looks incredible. Two very different worlds collide in this extraordinary looking way.
They've managed to marry all these images of medieval warriors and then modern day European police, and it's kind of seamless.
The visuals in Kingsglaive, they're pretty awesome, and it's all motion capture.
Action.
But it's all just brilliantly animated, and the world they painted for me to play in is pretty magical.
And it's fascinating to think that this was all created on a computer, because I've never seen anything that's so realistic that actually is emotional as well.
The crystal will not serve you.
It's not difficult to get into the characters because they are so emotionally involved and they're so emotionally challenging and so real.
My wings have been clipped in case you didn't know!
People are going to love this movie. Blood, sweat, and tears went into this. I'm just very happy to lend my voice to this incredible, complex character. And
how the hell did they find us?
Doing voice work has its challenges. There's something lovely when you find your pace and you can bring them to life vocally. It's just a different way of acting. It's almost freer.
Anyone would wish the same for family they love.
This universe, you know, the gaming universe, is so dedicated and so devoted.
This was kept a secret from everyone for the past 3 years.
It's a pleasure being part of something that is, you know, so anticipated.
I just hope people get the opportunity to see it on a big screen, or as big as possible, because I think anybody who watches this will just be blown away by it.
focus.
No, he's a nice guy.
Iggy, look out.
Affirmative.
This is a living, breathing world of fantasy based on reality. Built with groundbreaking and cutting-edge technology, this is the ultimate action RPG, created for fresh faces to the series as well as longtime fans. This is the grand quest to reclaim your throne. This is Final Fantasy XV. Final Fantasy XV is set in the war-torn world of Eos. You are Noctis, the crown prince of the kingdom of Lucis, and your quest is to seize back your homeland from the clutches of the menacing imperial army, Niflheim.
There was an attack. The king was found dead.
Noctis and his three loyal companions must embark on an epic journey of brotherhood, exploration, and action as they unravel Noctis' destiny and take up arms against the invading Niflheim Empire. Noctis is heir to the throne and the only son of King Regis. His dislike of the restrictions of the royal family and his casual attitude belies his strong desire to protect those around him. In combat, Noctis wields spectral weapons which he forges from thin air, a power possessed by those of his royal line.
Now is not the time to question your calling.
Noctis's friend Prompto is the life and soul of the team. Fast friends with Noctis since they met as teenagers, Prompto is a young man of common birth who finds himself out of his depth when tragedy befalls Lucis.
We go back to Insomnia.
Might not be safe for us there.
Might not be safe for us here.
Although he's the weakest and youngest member of the team, his masterful gunplay makes Prompto a valuable ally during skirmishes. Prompto's favorite hobby is photography, and the photos he takes on your journey can be shared on social networks.
This one's pretty good.
I dig it too.
Gladio is Noctis' eldest companion, and his family has long served as the shield protecting the kings of Lucis. However, the bond Gladio shares with Noctis transcends that of a bodyguard and his liege.
I gotcha!
Gladio's strength means he can charge at the enemy's ranks and wreak havoc over a wide area. As a survivalist, Gladio will retrieve ever more useful items at the end of battles as his ability develops.
When you can't focus, I focus for you. It's my job.
Ignis is the most thoughtful of Noctis' companions and was raised alongside the prince to be advisor to the heir apparent.
I'll analyze what intelligence we have available to find us a way in.
When it comes to fighting, he wields dual daggers with deadly efficiency. Ignis can also mark multiple enemies on the field, setting up Noctis to warp strike each of them in succession. As the team cook, he crafts dishes that would impress any restaurant with their look, smell, and taste while also offering stat bonuses to the party.
I've come up with a new recipe.
There is a strong supporting cast in Final Fantasy XV, weaving a complex and compelling story. The principal characters include Luna, Princess of Tenebrae, and lifelong friend of Noctis. She is also the youngest oracle in history with an inborn ability to speak to the gods.
Goddess of the seas, I beseech you!
Regis, the fallen king of Lucis, and his adversaries, Aedalus and Ardyn, Emperor and Chancellor of Niflheim respectively, provide the backbone to the overall story, filled with treachery, violence, and mystery. Final Fantasy XV's combat system offers an intoxicating blend of magic spells, summons, and real-time battle action. User-friendly and with hidden depths, the system lets you strike not only with a vast array of hardware and magic, but to also exploit the skills and weaponry of your comrades. But don't forget to have a solid defense, where parrying, countering, and dodging your foe's attacks will also be key to victory. Using Noctis' unique warp ability, you can quickly get into the action with a long-range attack or deftly dodge incoming attacks. You can also warp out to safety to assess the battlefield or to regain precious health. For those who would prefer to slow things down while in the heat of battle, there's wait mode. While in wait mode, the player can freely target enemies, aim magic spells, select teammate abilities, and more.
Who are you after this time?
Throughout your travels, you will also find and be able to purchase powerful weapons and accessories for Noctis and the gang. You can map different weapons and magic to the D-pad, meaning they can be easily switched during combat to suit your personal fighting style.
Hell yeah!
Yeah!
Last but certainly not least, your choice of outfit can also support you in combat. Noctis and his comrades can be fully customized with a range of outfits, all of which come with their own unique stat boosts. Magic will be an important weapon in your arsenal and is collected from elemental spots throughout the map. It can be crafted and loaded into the inventory at a set amount of your choice. The more you invest into a specific magic type, the stronger and more effective it will become when used in battle. Magic can also be combined with other items to give it special attributes.
You're on fire today!
As you journey through Final Fantasy XV, the party will earn ability points by leveling up and completing quests.
Well done, men.
These are used in the Ascension system to activate nexuses that will grant the characters new and exciting skills to aid you on your journey. Customize Noctis in the party to match your playing style. A Of course, no Final Fantasy game would be complete without the power of summoned beings. In Final Fantasy XV, you can summon ferocious and awe-inspiring beings called Astrals. Seeking them out and calling upon their powers will provide earth-shattering strength for your battles. The world of Eos is so epic that you'll need to do more than explore only on foot. To enable your road trip of a lifetime, you have the most extravagant of cars.
Would you care to take her for a little test drive, Noct?
The Regalia is your main mode of transport and will allow you fast passage between major locations. But to get close to the action and explore in depth, you'll have to do so on foot or via Chocobo. Oh, and by the way, from a certain point in the journey, it'll be possible for the Regalia to fly.
Whoa! This is awesome!
Final Fantasy XV includes a plethora of side quests, which are available to you throughout your journey. Some will relate to the main story, giving information on other happenings in the world and insight into the many characters you'll meet along the way. Tipsters in the world give you the opportunity to carry out monster hunts to gain valuable experience and a cash reward. Your hunter rank increases as you complete these quests, which in turn allows you to undertake more challenging hunts with even greater rewards. Happy hunting! Havens are locations dotted throughout Eos where the gang can safely recuperate from the day's events. Make a camp at these locations and utilize Ignis' cooking skills to create delicious and stat-boosting meals. At various locations in the world, you will find the game Justice Monsters 5. Hugely popular with Noctis and the residents of Lucis, this pinball game is fully playable in Final Fantasy XV and is also available to download now on mobile devices. Along with Justice Monsters 5, there are many other mini-games to discover and enjoy, such as fishing. Why not try your hand at catching the evening dinner?
You did good.
While exploring the vast realm of Eos, you will experience a world of wonder filled with beauty, tragedy, and excitement.
We should play again sometime.
Final Fantasy XV retains the legendary hallmarks of the Final Fantasy series, which has captivated players for nearly 30 years, while bringing you revolutionary gameplay, which has been developed with pioneering technology. Joined by your closest friends, take the wheel and embark on an epic adventure to fulfill your destiny. Fresh faces and longtime fans alike, take back your throne and experience a brand new kind of fantasy.